You know what I'm saying? So too, I'll be working hard to get it where we are. You still got to get home. And at the end of it, I was like, man, shit, I just kind of got my niggas make it home, sir. Because, and I was like, you know, Mike Brown must have been on third base. Trayvon must have been on third base. Ricky Paul must have been on third base. Just because that shit is just as important, bro. Like, it shouldn't matter what city you're from, what color your skin is, who your parents are, how much money they make. If a child's life is taken, that shit is a tragedy every single time. We get numb to it because it's happening at such an alarming rate. But it's still a tragedy, bro.
So what should we do? What should we do about it?
I don't know what we should do. I know what I'm going to do.
I know what
I should do. And I should do I should use what God gave me. The same way that God has given you the ability to put these, to track these people down and get them to speak on things. That's your job. If you utilize that to put this shit on a platform and speak about it, conversation with the nation. So that means if God has given me the ability to pin these words to these beats in a manner that can be articulated across scale, I can speak to the president and the ex-con that murdered in jail. I have, bro, on the same day. I spoke to the president of the United States and the ex-con who was on trial for murder in the same day, and they both understood me. So I know I got to use that to fix the problem.
So what you were talking about, you got to speak on that. That's big, bro. What was you talking to Obama? What y'all talked about, man?
Well, he came to Columbus. He came to the W in Columbus, and I just was the student body president at the school. That's literally it. I just was hosting it. And we went to Little Dewey's, took him to Little Dewey's, and just sat down and talked. And he asked me, you know, he basically was asking me questions. He was interviewing me, you know, what do you feel like America needs help with the most? What do you feel like we're good at? You know, and he was just asking these questions. And I felt like this was routine. But I didn't take it as a routine opportunity. I articulated myself to where he felt me. I needed him to know that he was me. He is me right now. Just because I'm from Northside Columbus, Mississippi, and I'm graduated from Columbus High School, doesn't mean that anything in my brain is different from what you're capable of in your brain. Mm. And I was just letting, I was like, not because of how I look, or because of, I said, my environment affects the choices I make. The choices I make the choices I make are gonna affect my destiny. So what I'm saying is, like, I look at life as a pyramid, upside down pyramid, and I can get deep into this if you want to, but it's like
it's all good, man. Do you, bro? Ain't no time
out. It's binary, you know what I'm saying? It's binary. It's zeros and ones. So every decision you make boils down to good and bad, like a yes and no. Like, you're gonna say, are you hungry? Yes. Okay, that means you eat. Or you can say, are you hungry? No, that means you don't eat. But then there's two more doors that open behind each of those doors that lead you to a different path. But ultimately, like an upside-down triangle, you don't get to one point. Whatever your fate is, it determines. That's the way that God designed the universe, to have all this randomness, all this entropy in the world for it to be one destiny, and that's for good to overrule. But we just got to make decisions that are going to affect our path. Ultimately, we're going to get to this point. And by me understanding that gives me the power to go ahead and just do the shit without concern about the circumstance. Because ultimately, we all going to get to one point. It's destiny, it's fate. Random as our decision-making can be, it's going to get to one point. And now, I operate on that belief.
I would say it's funny when you say that, because, like, one of my favorite Jay-Z verses, when he was like, you was who you was before you got here. So that's basically what you're saying. Like, it's already, right. We basically going through this shit, but it's already determined what's going to happen. But we don't know, but he know. We don't know, yeah.
Exactly, man. You ever heard, like, an old head OG talk about, you know what I'm saying, all the things that he did, you know what I'm saying, and then now he at the point where he is now, like a pastor. He has a historical background with crime and drugs and all that. And it's just amazing to see how many people are mesmerized by his story. When I'm like, bro, this is our story. This is everybody's story. What I'm saying is, you didn't think you would be able to live in San Diego, California at one point. Because you were living in Columbus, Mississippi. That don't change the fact that you're living in San Diego, California right now. And I'm sure there's a lot of good days and a lot of bad days in between it. But at this point right now, you're living in San Diego, California.
Yeah, I'm saying
that's exactly.
The thing was, when I was in Columbus, Mississippi, I wasn't even thinking about. I was always thinking like, I'm gonna live in Columbus for my life. I wasn't even thinking about other places. That was a crazy part. Yeah.
And that's evolution of the mind. Like, I mean, ultimately, as a child, you grow to think. When you first born, you go to think the hospital room is the only place in the world, and getting to your mama is the most important thing because she can feed you. She can comfort you, she can put you to sleep, and she can clothe. And that's just natural evolution. It's for you to grow as your understanding to grow as you grow. As you experience, your understanding grows. But then we go, we're like, all right, well, shit, it's bigger than this hospital room. I got a home now. All right, well, shit, other people got homes too. So it's obviously bigger than my home. It's our neighborhood. It's like, well, shit, well, he ain't from my neighborhood, so it's bigger than our neighborhood. It's got a whole city. He just developed. And what I grew uncomfortable with is how people can get to a point where they stop developing or evolving. Hmm. I think that we're meant to learn and to evolve and to grow as long as we're alive.
So what are some ways that you can evolve and grow? I mean, I feel you on everything. Like, we saying, but I'm just, we talking to the listeners. Like, anybody listening, yeah.
I'm grateful for the question, because, I mean, honestly, I answer the question all based off of fear. So I just start talking, man, let the universe really just align the messages. So when you ask these questions, it makes me part of these things, and I answer them, right, really sure. Listening to myself to develop, to get an answer as well. And a lot of ways we can go and develop ourselves, honestly, are instinct. You know what I'm saying? Learning to trust our instincts more, man. It's certain things that our body, our mind, our spirit tell us. Our body and our spirit tell us that our mind has been oppressed to think is wrong. But what I'm telling you is, if you naturally feel better when something happens, it's probably better for you, right? So for me, I was a kid who, I think when I was around 16, 17 years old, I had lost so many people to marijuana. I had lost so much time to marijuana, for my family members going to jail and being killed and all that. I was like, I'll never smoke weed, I'll never do that. And I remember saying that and being like really stern and devout about my dedication to that statement.
I'm smoking right now.
Right. And then I evolved, right? I went to college. I experienced different things. And then I grew to understand that, okay, maybe I was giving incorrect information. And this is the most appalling thing that happens to me, is I have conversations with people who don't want to develop or grow about the misinformation that we're given. Like, as a collective, we just decided that there's no more Christopher Columbus Day this past year. As a collective, we've been decided this in our mind because it never made sense. It never made sense in our mind why we would celebrate Christopher Columbus Day, why we would think America was founded in 1492, when Native Americans have been traced back here to way before 700 AD, you know what I mean? So it's just like, well, if a system keeps perpetuating lies, then I'm not saying call them a liar every time they speak. I'm saying research and find out for yourself instead of taking their word for it if they burn you so many times.
I'm going to say, I know with me, but with me, man, I know, like what you saying, like, I feel you, because I know, like, we get a lot of misinformation, but to the average person, they go with it. So you can't be, like, always, like, because you just look crazy to them if you always, like, speaking on it. So I don't even know what to do. I just got to stay quiet.
Yeah, man, I literally lead by example, bro. I deal with these rappers. I deal with rappers in my city, in my area, in my fucking, I love these guys for death. That's why I decided to stop talking so much and started doing so much. Hmm. Like, it's a real, I'm poor right now. I don't claim that, but that's my current circumstance. I'm homeless. I don't have a home right now. I'm living in my car. I drive to my show, get paid, and I go out to the next show. And what I'm telling them people is that I gave me this power. I decided a long time ago that nothing was going to stop me. And then I decided that I was going to make it happen by doing it. Not waiting on nobody to find me. I don't care about getting signed. Like, eventually, people will need me as a resource on how to make it happen, because I'm going to do it. I'm going to operate on that level of faith.
I feel you, man.
Understanding the God power that's within me. Not the God power that I have to search for. I found God in the mirror.
Yeah, actually.
You talking about somebody who was teaching Sunday school class at 12 years old, a grown man Sunday school class. Mm. I ain't find God until I looked in the mirror. Harriet Tubman ain't wait for Jesus, the sweet chariot, to come back. She found God in the mirror. And then 3,000 slaves later, she's still going to slave in New Orleans. And saying, we got to make it happen. We are the resource.
You going into, because I was going to ask you about, man, I really like that song. Like, and that's actually what I'm studying right now. Because that's basically like, I don't know if you ever heard of New Thought, but New Thought is basically kind of like what you're saying. Like, we are gods. Like, in that song, what are we of gods?
Right,
you know,
right.
I'm reading that book, and the book is basically, he's talking about everything in the Bible, but he's just breaking it down on, like, we are gods. And
exactly,
like,
bro. And I look at it as all, I read the entire Bible before I was 10 years old. And I still cannot take away from the power it is as a literary piece, as a metaphorical reference to how we are to abide and live our lives, saying that no matter if it's Jesus Christ, if it's Buddha, if it's Heros, the sun god,
right,
or,
just symbols.
Know, these are metaphorical references for you to strive for that type of power, that type of perfection on earth. Not to seek the spiritual God, because we understand that the spiritual God as a deity exists. We feel him without knowing his presence. But then we disseminate that power once it gets to the human level. And these religions all put these as an example of you attaining that power. Not saying that it's easy. Not saying that it's something you can do overnight. You can just decide, okay, well, I'm going to have Jesus-like power right now. I'm saying you gotta train your mind. You got to train your spirit to look within yourself for a resource. I'm saying you don't even got to eat no food. You can eventually get to the same kind of faith, the same kind of belief that all these parables spoke about of these people in the wilderness when the rocks turned into bread, when the 5,000 fish people, when 5,000 people were fed, you know, saying two fish and five loaves of bread. These are all, you know, when Job had everything taken from him, and he still operated on that faith. These are all metaphorical references to you to achieve higher elevation.
Mm.
When you read that, when you read Shakespeare, you feel love that Romeo and Juliet had, because it was one point in time where you were told you couldn't talk to that girl. And there was no other reason other than y'all were different. And you knew that difference didn't make a difference. It just was something that you was told. And you can relate to that. I'm saying, that's how we're supposed to look at the Bible. That's how we're supposed to look at the Torah, the Quran. All of these prophetic teachings are to get us to understand that we have that power. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Let me know that Philippians 4:13 lets me know that I got that power. If the Bible says I can do all things, not we can do all things when God conjoins with me, it says I can do all things through the God that was exemplary on earth, which is in Christian faith, and it's Jesus. But in a different faith, it's something else. It doesn't matter if your name is Malcolm Little or, you know what I'm saying, Doc, you know, whatever it is, man, do right.
But I would say, you were saying something that I want to ask you about, because you were talking about training your mind, and actually, like, the book was telling. I mean, I just been realizing, because, like I said, me, man, I've been just really, like I'm into psychology and, you know, education-wise, but I've really been on that personal development path for, like, since 2006. So I really realize now is just what you think about. So when you say train your mind, I realize that, because really with me, like, I'd be like, shit, all I think about is just what I want to do in life and my radio show, and I realize it's growing, but I realize it's kind of hard to just sit there and really think about that shit all day, but when you do it that shit works. So do you do that? Is that something, when you saying train your mind, I just want to hear about the training your mind part, what you was talking about, like, go deep on that.
I mean, you know, I feel as though that's like your most powerful driving force, your mind, because like you literally can create things in your mind that aren't there. You know, like nightmares and dreams. Look at the power that we have to recollect things that we don't need to experience in our dreams. It's because your mind has more power than we have tapped into. Now, I mean, that's scientific. So, you know, that's scientifically proven. So, that we don't use 100% of our 100% of our brain. So, with that being said, that allows me to know that there's more that we can achieve. And if there's more that we can achieve in our mind physically, then there's more that we can achieve in our mind spiritually. So, if you read books with different words every single day, your vocabulary is going to grow naturally. So if you access power that you don't know is there every single day in your mind, eventually those things will become tangible. Like, I started doing this I started saying things a lot. I said, last year I was like, man, I need to meet Chris. I need to meet Chris. I need to meet Chris. Because not only is he a big inspiration, but, you know what I'm saying?